Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Hometown Cable. Wild Bill Chase, beautiful downtown Saranac, where the Bobcats of Northern Adirondack have traveled to play the Chiefs. It's Saturday morning again, and we're waiting for the Chiefs to take the floor. This is going to be a JV contest. First time I've actually done a JV game this year featuring the Bobcats. We've got Ben Boyer, Doug Alexander, Ben Fiveson, Tyler Brassard, and who's number 25? Where is he? Alan Brassard. Bobcats win the tip. We'll let you know who's out there for Saranac. Senior day here. Foul, number 32. Number 32 would be the hardest name there that I've... Kurunski. Tiber Kurunski. I don't know if that's close, but that's what it's going to be most of the day. Doug Alexander on the line shooting two. First one's good. It's a 1-0 lead. Also out for there for Saranac. We got number 15, Connor Thompson. Number 21 is Sean Wood. Alexander hits them both. Number 42 is Cody Russell. I've got one more player to tell you who's playing for Saranac. Kurunski with a double dribble. Bobcats move the ball up over the press. Doug Alexander converts. He's got the first 4 points of the ball game. Bobcats show their own press. Tom Russell, Cody, that's number 21, Sean Wood. First points for Saranac. Saturday morning, it's going to take me a few minutes to get it to names and track. And a steal on that press. Number 22 is the other kid out there. Kevin Cross for Saranac. Alexander's pass is picked off. And now we got a foul. I know Lenny Duquette's one of the officials. I'm not sure who the other one. Leonard Welch doing the coaching for the Bobcats. As head coach Zach Welch, I believe he's got a commitment with Plattsburgh State Baseball. Head coach for Saranac is Brent Denise. Connor Thompson, he's 15. Wood, 22. Oh, Wood's 21. Brassard comes down with a ball. It's a 4-4 game. That's stolen away. Oh, telegraphing that pass. And the ball put down to the post. Number 21, Sean Wood on the receiving end of that pass. He's fouled by Ben Boyer. 6:41 on the clock. It's 6-4. The Bobcats started out with a 4-0 lead, but Saranac has answered with six straight points of their own. They have the 2-point lead. It's a 3-pointer, line drive free throw. We got a foul on the reach in there by number 42, Cody Russell. Russell, oh, I remember that kid. He's there. I believe he was a JV goalie. Very good athlete from what I remember. I remember out of soccer, that is. There's a pass by Ben Fiveson. A little bit too much mustard on it. Threw it over the arms of Doug Alexander. Inbounding is Wood. Kurunski. Puts it up to... That shot's off the mark. Boyer comes down with a rebound. Cody Russell, 42. Doug Alexander pops a shot. Doesn't go. Rebound. Alexander gets his own. We call it travel. JV basketball here. Bobcats and Chiefs. Bobcats of Northern Adirondack. The Chiefs of Saranac. It's Saturday morning, February 5th. 1 day before the big day of... Super Bowl Sunday, that's tomorrow, folks. Yeah, being held in February this year. Oh, other important dates in February. We all had Groundhog Day is already passed. That's out of bounds. It'll be a Bobcat ball. We got Valentine's Day. The Fleecing of the Male Species Day, sometimes known as Valentine's Day. Well, another steal. The press. Two on one there, and 21 passes out to 22. That's Wood giving it up to Cross. Another steal. Russell with the ball. His shot's a little bit short. And pass across into through traffic on through the hands of Wood, but Saranac maintains possession as he ran down that loose ball. Thompson to Karunsky. His shot's off the mark. Thompson now again finds Karunsky underneath, wide open. And the Cats with a good start. And a foul on number 15. What? Foul on, I guess it was on NAC, Tyler Brassard. Ben Boyeson, or Ben Fiveson is out. Derek Jubert is in for Fiveson. Saranac moving the ball. It's 11-4 game, 11 straight points. Karunsky. I don't know how much of this I'm going to record. It's going to continue. Jubert with the ball. Pass to Boye. Ball's out of bounds. That's a travel right there. The feet just shuffled. Russell with the ball. Saranac, patience on offense. They go up 13-4. 3-point attempt. That's a little bit short. Runzi. He gets the rebound. Now Russell gets a rebound. Russell trying to force something that's not there. Loose ball picked up by Doug Alexander. He dishes off to Ben Fiveson. Fiveson gives to Jubert. That's Derek Jubert. That's a foul, too. There'd be a no foul call. Looked like he was hacked. Thompson's out. Number 11, Ryan LeBleu, is in. Russell. That's thrown. Down towards the baseline. He can't handle the pass. He was cutting, but it looked like he pulled up. His teammate had the right idea. Fouls on number 22. Kevin Cross. Bobcat basketball, hometown cable. Your ultimate high school sports network in Clinton County. We're in the beautiful gymnasium here at Saranac. This gym's at least 4 or 5 years old. Fiveson shot. It's blocked by Karunzi. Runzi pulls up, drops it in. It is 15-4. Doug Alexander, the bounce pass to Boye. And the foul is going to be called on number 11, Ryan LeBeau. Ben Boye. First one short. Doug Alexander, the only member of the Bobcat team to score any points thus far. Two on them. Foul shots. Oh, Ben Boye, he's now the second player on the team with a point. Makes one of two. Cody Russell's got to pull it back out. Gives it to Wood. Wood chokes. It's off the mark. LeBeau, back to Wood. Swings it over to Cross. Cross, three-point attempt. Doesn't go. That's over the back, finally, okay. Both teams with, I was gonna say four team fouls, but now Saranac has five team fouls. And we got 2:54 here to go. Quite a few whistles here in the early going. Karunzi with a nice play. Pass was down court, but he got there before Fiveson. to Rumsey, to Russell. Russell, LeBeau, three-point attempt. That's wide. Woods there, pops a shot. Kerunzi on the putback, but Doug Alexander pulls down a rebound there. Ball's knocked out of his hands, go out of bounds. Bobcat ball. Serenite continues with the full court press here. 2.5 minutes left in the first quarter. This game started at 11 a.m. Ben Bivison saying, hey, you're supposed to go long. And Ben Boyer was actually coming the other way at him. Cross, his shot, doesn't go. Boyer pulls down the rebound. Brassard gives it to Bivison. Bivison back to Brassard. Kerunzi, another hand in there defensively. Find Cross cutting to the basket. Oh, that's Wood, excuse me. I'm mixing Wood and Cross up. Hey guys, number 32 in the red shorts and the white jerseys, not on your team. Hey, get away from me. Okay, we didn't miss much. I was a little bit interrupted by some relatives of mine on the Chase side of the family who live over here in the Saranac School District. Kimberly and her sister. I forgot her sister's name. Well, it's 19-7. We're in the second quarter. Bobcats had jumped out to a 4-0 lead, but then it was all Indians pretty much throughout that first quarter. I think it was Alan Brassard hit a jump shot just before the buzzers to end the first quarter, and then gave them Bobcats two more points. Nice hustle there by Saranac player number 55. That'd be Brian Tedford. I think we've got five new players out there for the Chiefs here. So the Bobcats, they've only used six.
35-second clock goes off. There's a shot
clock violation, so the Bobcats will get the ball back. 6:56 on the clock, second quarter action. But that hadn't hit the rim yet. That's a good call. So five new legs out there, set of legs for the Tedford causing. No, he's called a foul. I thought he was. Fouls on Tedford. Tedford, number 25, is Conway. Who else we got out there? We got a number 33, Nick Thibault. Number 45 is Matt Scallon. And well, I put the Bobcats into the bonus. Cats have three team fouls. I think I earlier reported they had four, but well, the Chiefs got eight. Made one of two, Mr. Brassard did, and now on the scramble, Bobcats, Doug Alexander picking up the loose ball after on the rebound of the second shot that didn't go, and he nails the jump shot. It's 19-10 now. Well, here's the other kid. We did not mention his name yet. Line drive shot. Wow, what a friendly roll there. That should have never went in. That's Richard Chase. That's a relative of mine. We shouldn't forget number 13 then. He's the Chase kid. Come on, we got to make better passes out there. Chase moves to his left. gives it to Conway. Chase goes down low to Tedford. Tedford turns and he scores. Catching, turning, and shooting. Brasser almost losing the ball to Conway. Conway on the floor. He does take it away. Nope, he stepped on the line. So it'll be the Bobcat ball. Good work there by Mr. Conway. 5.5 minutes left in the second quarter. 23-10. A beautiful morning. It's going to be a beautiful day here. February 2005. Temperatures are supposed to reach into the close to 40 degrees over the weekend. It's supposed to be a lot of sunshine, and we've had a tremendous amount of sunshine in the last 7 to 10 days. It's just started out cold maybe 10 days ago, but then it's gradually warmed up, and now we're going to be pushing the 40 degree mark. Dylan the villain. Lajway's in there. He's number 31 playing for the Bobcats. Brasser got a hand on that, but Conway ends up picking up the loose ball. Chase, no, that's not Chase. That's 33 is Tebow. Tebow goes down low to Tedford. Tedford spin move. Can't convert. Tedford getting his own rebound as the Bobcats had it. It's tipped back up. That's through the hands of Joubert. Loose ball. Grab the thing. That was a hot potato today there. Conway. Pass is picked off by Tedford. Tedford takes it himself. Conway pulls down a rebound on the putback. It's up and in. That's a 25-10 game. Dylan. I think it's Dylan Mahoney. It's Dylan Lajway. Joubert. Gives it to Brasser. Brasser, that's in and out. Tedford comes up with a rebound. He gives it to Tebow. Tebow driving. Off balance. Little underhanded action, and it falls in for him. That's out of bounds off in the foot of Tyler Brasser. We got a timeout call, 3:54 on the clock. It's 27-10. The Chiefs got a commanding 17-point lead over the Bobcats here on Hometown Cable JV basketball action. Conway inbounds to Chase. Number 53 in the game, I believe. It's Rose, Jonathan Rose. Alexander gets a hand on that. That's Doug Alexander. Doug played on the varsity team during the Bobcat shootout. Up to Coach Recor, head coach for Northern Adirondack varsity, elected to see Doug stay down in the JV level and get a tremendous amount of playing time. Wouldn't be surprised to see Doug get moved up for sectional play. Lashway with a nice job to make sure that ball didn't get stolen away. Bobcats with better ball movement. Alexander trying to force something down to Boye, and that's tapped away, and here comes Chase with the ball. Richard Chase. Back to Tebow. Gives it back to Chase. They play a little pitch and quetch. They swing it over here to Conway. Tebow finds Rose. Rose drives down. He tries to pass it to a teammate. So then we got 3-second violation on number 55, Mr. Tedford. Conway with a foul. That's going to bring Pivison down the other end. He'll shoot 1-1. Pivison makes the first one. He'll get to shoot the second one. Second, next time the Bobcats are fouled, it's a double bonus situation. It'll be 10 fouls in this half against the Chiefs. So they get to shoot two no matter what. The remainder of this half, there's 3 minutes exactly on the clock. It's 27-11. Tedford comes down with a rebound. So he used his body to keep Doug Alexander away from that ball. T-ball gives to Chase. Chase, three-point attempt, line drive. That hits the rim, comes into down into the arms of Joubert. Pivotson up to Alexander. Alexander again trying to send that ball into Ben Boyer's area. That's a little too high for Boyer to catch. And Cats turn it over again. Conway. Chase. Well, this is Chase now. Conway. Three-pointer? No, I don't think so. Little Doug Alexander comes down with the ball. It's senior night here, or senior afternoon, senior day or something. So they'll probably have a ceremony. It appears they got four senior basketball players, Ben Boye underneath. And that miss by Alexander put it back up and scores. It's 27-13. I'm going to have to move over. There's enough traffic going up and down these stairs during this JV game. 3 second violation again. 1:48 on the clock. Four varsity players are seniors and three varsity cheerleaders are seniors. But we won't be recording any of that. One of the longest senior night ceremonies I've ever seen was held here right in Saranac. Senior night for girls varsity soccer. I was the official. They were playing Mariah, which was here with Stan Riggs, and it was a cold night. And in that cold weather, it lasted a good 20 minutes. Doug Alexander from outside doesn't go. Tebow, Sarah, pull down the rebound. Alexander was down the floor more or less by himself. Didn't appear to have too many other Bobcats around him. Rolls his shot. That hit the top of the backboard. Isn't that... Tedford's out. I'm not quite sure who came in for him. Oh, number 45's back in the game. There's a shot put up by Tebow. Nothing but net. It's 29-13. We're down to less than a minute left. That ball's out of bounds. Dylan Lashway couldn't handle the pass from Fivenson. Scallion. Matt Scallion. Replacing the young Tedford guy, basketball player. Conway to Rose. They go down low. To Chase. Chase in a mismatch. A mismatch in size with Ben Boye on him. Boye reached around and fouled him. Bobcats still got one foul to give. Only got five called against him in this half. Rose will inbounds. Conway. Rose finds Chase. Three-second violation on somebody. Ben Boye on the line, 21.2 seconds on the clock. He's shooting two free throws, he makes one. Bobcats, actually one of their bright spots of this first half has been their free throw shooting. I think they've only had two misses. Wow, a little scoop between two Bobcat defenders, got the shot off. Chase on a pass from his teammate. Conway, that's off his foot, out of bounds. It'll be Bobcat ball. 6.3 seconds on the clock. They are down by 14 points. First squad built up the lead, and the second squad for the Chiefs has more or less kept that lead. Joubert, Doug Alexander on a putback. That's good. Nice play by Alexander. Well, in the air, put the ball back up quickly before the horn blew. And the Cats I've cut it down to a 12-point game. 29-17, a much better second quarter there for the Bobcats than they had in the first quarter. Wild Bill Chase in beautiful downtown Saranac. We'll be back with second half action of JV basketball. Northern Adirondack in Saranac, 29-17 at the half. Okay, now as the NAC JV cheering squad has gotten out of the way, we can get this second half underway. 29-17. The first starting five come out for Saranac. Russell, that shot partially blocked by Alexander. That's Wood putting up the shot, and he scores, makes it 31-17. Stolen away, Alan Brasser just throwing that into the hands of number 15, Connor Thompson. Four quick points for Saranac. Doug Alexander been trying that move all day. Some kind of a little, that one was a little, I'm trying to alley-oop it to Ben Boye. Thompson's down in the corner. Wild Bill Chase here in Saranac. We're at Pickett's Corners. The Chiefs and Bobcats tangling in boys JV basketball action, that is. Varsity game to follow. This is senior day here in Saranac. Last game of the regular season at home for the seniors. We'll have a pregame ceremony, I'm sure. 11 o'clock start on this JV game. Doug Alexander with a good position on Karunsky. Brasser, though, picking up a loose ball on the foul line. Lear takes a shot and banks it in. It's 33-19. Russell trying to send that ball into Wood. Brassard steps in front of it. Fiveson getting on the floor with some good hustle there. Knocks the ball out of bounds. The Chiefs will maintain possession. Wood will inbound to Thompson. Cross now with the ball. Karunsky. He banks it home. 35-19. We've seen some shots that's, I don't know, some other gymnasiums, they might not go, but these rims here have been, and backboards have been quite friendly to Saranac. What was that call? I think he called double dribble, but it didn't look like to me that he put two hands on it. I don't know. I'm paying attention to the camera and trying to figure out who's on the floor, so could be Karunsky on a baseline. Puts it up and in, 37-19. Good start here of the third quarter for the Chiefs. Super Bowl Sunday's tomorrow. Today's February 5th. It's Saturday. Basketball here on Hometown Cable. Doug Alexander using his body to shield off the defender, and he was fouled. He'll go to the line to shoot two. Doug Alexander makes the first one. Second one's good. Well, nice hustle there by Wood to save the ball. But he put it into the hands of Fiveson. Brasser gets it to Boye, kicks it back out to Brasser. Brassard shot's good. It's only a two-pointer, but going inside and back out worked for the Bobcats that time. Wood moves around the defender. He hustles to get his own rebound. Kicks it back out, and a foul called. 4:59 on the clock here in the third quarter. It's a 37-23 ball game. 14-point lead by the Chiefs. Wild Bill Chase here. Beautiful downtown Pickett's Corners. Oh, repeat myself again. Wood, his shot's off the mark. Alexander with a good position down underneath gets the rebound. Fiveson to Brasser. Brasser goes into traffic. And he had it look like to his left was the better move. Ben Boye, that's in and out. The friendly rolls have been going Saranac's way. Cross, back to Wood. That doesn't go. Cross gets the rebound. Kicks it out to Russell. Russell thought about taking a shot. Swings it over to Thompson. Thompson hits the three-pointer. It's a 40-23 ball game. Alexander sends it across court, and that's actually behind Allen Brassard. Out of bounds. Going to be here to do the varsity game also. Bobcats coming off a tough night against Tupper Lake. After having an outstanding offensive night against Seton on Tuesday night, Thursday night, they struggled all night long to score in points and actually ended up losing them. Forgot the score now. Calling a foul? Okay. Carunzi with the foul. And now his replacement, number 45, Matt Scallion. Carunzi went into the stands, banged his knees. His coach took him out. 42-23. Chiefs on top of the Bobcats. Varsity boys are making their way to the locker room. Get ready. Sure, we gotta wonder which team's gonna show up tonight for another round acre this afternoon. The team that scored 70 points against Seton or the team that struggled against Tupper Lake. Gary Castine, he's the head coach, brother of Calvin Castine. The man, the myth, the legend of Hometown Cable, that'd be Calvin. Wood driving, can't get it to go. Boye comes down with a rebound. A floater of a pass by Brassard. Boye, that's off the back rim. Cross, he lays it up, scores. Thompson. Why this cord? Keep stepping on it. Next stoppage of play. I gotta pull this thing off the floor. Thompson, three-pointer, a little bit short. Scallion actually taps that ball to Brassard. Brassard, double team by Wood and Thompson. Thompson gets Brassard up in the air, puts it up and in. 45-23, or is it 47? Doug Alexander. There's a foul called on Thompson. .211 on the clock. Cats continue to shoot well from the free throw line. Zubert, that is Derek, coming in for Tyler Brassard. Oh, Mitchell Rowell is out there. I didn't notice that. He must have replaced the Pipeson. There's number 21, Mitchell Rowell. So what are we going to do? Shooting two again? And that first one by Doug doesn't count? Oh, Boye says, well, I'll fix you guys. So we've made two in a row here, but the first one don't count. Had the wrong shooter on the line. Boye gets them both. Three foul shots. They make them all, but they only get to count 2 points. Well, that's the way it goes. Nice pass there to Wood. Cut to the basket, but he doesn't convert. Put the ball down on the ground. That's Cross getting a hand on that, knocking it out of bounds. Basketball, you got to play basketball, and well, just any game, you got to play with a lot of confidence. And some of the players
here need some confidence building.
Rowell gets it to Joubert. Taking away the going up the side of the court. Hey, what's going on? Cross. Who's that? Number 11 in the game now. It'll be LeBeau. Wood put up another shot. He's put up a lot of shots here in his third quarter. He's made a few, but well. Gotta keep shooting, whether you're hot or cold. That was number 45, Scallion, breaking down by himself. But he doesn't convert the layup. Ball goes out of bounds, 109 on the clock. There's Wood. He gets that one to go. He's been working hard. I'll give him that credit there. Alexander moves to his right. A little bit short. Brassard crashing the boards. Somebody's going to be called for a travel. Not quite sure who that is. Oh, it's number 11, Ryan LeBeau. Rowell forcing something. Scallion getting a hand on it. Ben, you got to move. Oh, Brassard does. Catches, shoots, and scores. Nice play there. Got to move your feet in playing basketball. Can't be stationary. LeBeau over to Cross. Cross to Wood. Wood loves to shoot. Boyer. And now Cross fouls Mitchell Rowell. That'll be the fourth team foul on Saranac. There's 33 seconds exactly left in this third quarter. Saranac up by 12 at the half. They are up by 20, 47-27. Derek Joubert. That's an over and back violation. He lost control of the ball. That went in the backcourt. He goes and touches it. Turns it over to Saranac. Wood kicks it down to Russell. Russell moves to his left, kicks it back out. Three second violation, I think, on Scallion. 15.5 seconds on the clock. Joubert to Brassard, gets it up to Rowell. Rowell goes to Alexander. Alexander finds Boyer underneath. He scores. Nice play there by Alexander, and Ben Boyer completes the play. Time runs out. Ooh, looked like a pretty good shot, but just came up short. 47-29 here after three complete quarters. Saranac up by 18. Brassard inbound to Fiveson. Mitchell Rowell, Fiveson, Ben Boyer, Doug Alexander, Tyler Brassard out there for the Bobcats. The Chiefs put their second starting unit out. I guess the way to put it. I don't want to call them an A and B squad, but they don't skip a beat. Tripped up is Tebow. They got Richard Chase, Rose, Tedford, Tebow, and Conway out there for the Chiefs. 48-29. Because each squad has four of the Chiefs. Has done a pretty good job out there. Brassard comes down with a rebound. Gets it up to Alexander. That's out of bounds off of Tebow. Should be the Bobcat ball. And it is. Fourth quarter action in this JV contest here. Saturday morning, 11 o'clock start. Well, it's been a quick game. It's 11:55 here. Boyer moves to his right, round Tedford, up high off the glass and in. Good play there by Ben Boyer with a strong move to the hoop. It's 48-31. Bobcats, they beat Tupper Lake in JV contest the other night. Tonight, and all sorts of their hands full with the squad from Saranac. We're at Pickett's Corners. Wild Bill Chase. Iveson pulls up a little bit too long on that shot. Tebow with it. To the Chase. That's Richard Chase. That shot doesn't go. Iveson showing a little, being a little feisty out there. Feisty Iveson tries to get the ball to Boye. I don't know. There hasn't been a lot of passes in Ben Boye's direction that are sailing over the top of his head. I don't know if they think he's taller or what, but Boye makes a move. Doug Alexander in his own rebound. Again, rebound. This time. Doug, three cracks at it. Can't get it to go. Working hard, though, Alexander. Well, Doug Alexander, he's built a lot like Kyle Brassard. Long arms, lanky legs. Slender body. Alexander now with it. What's he doing? Mitchell Rowell, what a good job of hustling. Well, we got some, you don't want it, I'll take it, but here, give, let me give it back to you, action. Down low to Alexander. He tries to put that up off the glass, but Chase did a nice job of it defensively. Tebow with a stutter step. Foul called on Brassard. .529 left here in this contest. After that timeout, Saranac has the ball. Chase with it on a baseline, makes a move towards the basket, gives it to Tedford. Tedford's shot is blocked by Alexander. Iveson come up with the loose ball. Now Brassard. Brassard has a tendency, they can push him to the sidelines and then they double team him. He's got to get out of that habit. Allen Brassard. Chase quickly up to Conway. Conway off the glass and in, and that makes it a 50-31 ball game. Allen Brassard finds Doug Alexander. Alexander on a baseline. What a pretty move. He scores. 50-33. Chase, three-pointer, a little bit short. Alexander had it. Tapped out of his hand. Chase driving, picked up that loose ball. Now Doug Alexander again. Pulls up, gives the ball to Iveson. Dylan Lashway, he's back out there. Lashway being watched by Conway. Tyler Brassard, Lashway looking to set the pick on Tebow. Brassard puts it to Alexander, moves to his right. Again to his right. Nice play there by Doug Alexander. Rose, three-point land. Foul on Doug Alexander. 14 fouls now on the Bobcats. 14 fouls on Saranac here in the second half. 3:54 on the clock. Tiber Karunski. He's back in the game. Number 32. Brassard gets tied up by Tiber. Oh, we've been better off to call him Tiber all night. It's easier to say. It's his first name. Well, we're going to stick with that until the end. 3:48 now. Tiber will inbound the ball. Oh, it's Chase inbounding the ball. He gives it to Tiber. They swing it all the way around to Conway. Now Chase with inbound of the ball. He's there. his three-point attempt. Off the mark, Brasher gets tied up with Tebow. Possession arrow in favor of the Bobcats. Good hustle play there by Tebow. Full court pressure. Flashway. Brashard now gives it to Alexander. Alexander tries to go to Tyler Brashard. He can't hang on. The ball's out of bounds. Ryan LeBeau comes in for Richard Chase. Richard Chase, named after my uncle, Richard Chase. His grandfather is, I believe, a Richard Chase. Bugsy's his nickname. Like one of my first cousins. And Bugsy, and Henny Penny, Larry Lee, Allie, and Chi-Chi, otherwise known as Ronnie Chase. Watch Tebow. They're all brothers, those guys. Sons of Richards. Richard Chase Sr. used to be town highway superintendent in town of Dannemora. We watched Doug Alexander score a couple more points. LeBeau, three-point attempt. Short. Tebow's there from the elbow. Pops the shot. Scores. Nice through the hands of Brassard into one of the cheerleaders. Tebow will inbound. Saranac has the ball back. They are up 52-37. 15-point lead here in the late going of the fourth quarter. JV basketball here on Hometown Cable. It's the Chiefs of Saranac and Northern Adirondack Bobcats and JV boys basketball action. Saturday, February 5th. And the good weather continues out there, and we hope it does continue. Got a couple subs coming in for the Bobcats. Jordan Fave, number 14. Number 10, Ryan Goodrow. Somebody has called a timeout. 2:19 on the clock. Jordan Lefebvre and Goodrow out there for the Bobcats. Tebow nails a three-pointer here after that timeout. Tebow with the steal. His shot, wow. What's he put up? Seven straight points for the Chiefs. Oh, number 22 in the contest is, who's this guy? Kevin King. Derek Joubert out there. Mitchell Rao, Kevin King, Ryan Goodrow, and Jordan Lefebvre. The Bobcats here going to finish out this contest probably. That's off the leg of Rose and out of bounds. It'll be the Bobcat ball. And a 20-point lead for the Chiefs. They're going to pull out the victory here, folks. Joubert gets it to Rao. Foul called. A lot of elbows being thrown there. 5-second violation. That was an interesting exchange. Mitchell Rao looked like he continued to elbow the same guy. Chester, stomach area. He's on the line down there. He's out of bounds. That'd be Mr. Ryan LeBeau. Joubert. That's Derek Joubert. Surrounded by Chief defenders. Goodrow stops down. No, that was Lefebvre. Kevin King's now fouled. 16 fouls now on the Chiefs. It's going to be a hack. We're going to hack our way to the end here. 1:21 on the clock. Now we're going to shoot the 1-1. Derek Joubert on the line. 1:20 left in the clock. I don't know if I'm going to play much more of this. Probably running out of tape here, folks. Second game tonight, or this afternoon, will be the Bobcats And Chiefs tangling again, varsity level though. Boys varsity, that is. Bobcats finish out the regular season at home. They got senior night coming up against Northeastern Wednesday night. Then they travel to Sable, probably that'll be the third senior night in a row we're going to see. Because they'll have senior night. It'll be
well.
Tebow gives it to LeBeau. LeBeau scores 59-38. 1 minute exactly left here in the contest. Stolen away by Tedford. Tedford looking to take it himself. King fouls him. He'll go to the line to shoot two. Well, the Bobcats started out on the right foot. Had a 4-0 lead, but pretty much been two squads of Chiefs that have carried the play throughout here, and it's a 21-point lead, 59-38. Cats had a fairly good day, actually well above average day from the foul line. But the press, they just could not handle the press that the Chiefs used predominantly throughout this game. That's 60-38. Okay, folks, remember, everybody's beautiful in their own way. Even Wild Bill Chase. Okay, folks, we're going to wrap it up here. This ball game is 30 seconds away from being over. Oh, we might as well play it out. Remind you to stay tuned to Hometown Cable, your ultimate high school sports network in Clinton County. Calvin Castine and friends bringing you all sorts of high school sports, bowling, basketball, baseball, soccer, track and field, volleyball, wrestling. Calvin also covers a lot of local events, town meetings, parades, has some community interest programs. Him and Gordy Littleville do. Jarek Jubert hits the jump shot, makes it a 20-point game. LeBeau can't get it off. That's the game, folks. 60-40. Hometown Cable basketball action. The Chiefs by 20 over Northern Adirondack. Okay, Wild Bill Chase signing off on his JV game. Varsity game to follow. Let's enjoy the sunshine out there, folks, and let's hope this February just stays as the way it's been so far. Some great weather. But watch out. March is just around the corner. Good day, folks. Drive slow.